Horse people.
Well, what are we going to talk about today? We got forks. We got wine. We got toothpicks for afterwards. And we got a horsey. Buddy boy. All right. So what are we going to talk about? Well, if you read the title, you probably know why you're here. We're going to talk about finesse, balance, and how important it is when you're dealing with horses. So, most people know that horses have long, heavy necks and a big, heavy head. And that is a counterbalance to their body. They balance by using their head up and down in order to keep themselves balanced. So when you have large bits, and I put long shank bits here, when you have large shank bits here where you can pull and make the horse go down, or you have tie downs, a rope from here to here to tie down the horse, when you do that, you affect a horse's balance. Now, how hard is it and how easy is it to affect a balance? He's a big animal, right? I mean, look, if you look at the animal, the center is probably right here, right? Well, actually, the center's up more by his shoulders and closer up here. More like where his drive line is at. I talk about the drive line being in this area right here. You get behind this area, you push him forward. You get in front of this area, you push him back. So this is your drive line area here, which is probably the center part of the horse when he's trying to balance. But, so, we're talking about the head being used for balance, so restricting the head, using big bits, interferes with balance. We're talking about the position of the rider. If he's too far back or if it's too far forward, he can push the horse forward. When a horse starts bucking, usually you get in front. When you get in front is when you fall off, which is why when your horse is bucking, the lower you can get your back on the horse, if you watch the guys who ride bucking horses, they're always laying way back. Once you get your center of gravity, and center of gravity is kind of what we're talking about, once you lose that, you go over and you go off. Once you pull a horse's head off his center of balance, either the left or right, because you're using pain bits and you overpower him and you think you're being strong and empowered, you ruin the horse's balance. So how fine is balance? This is an old thing I remember in, it was probably grade school. So we're going to connect these two little forks here. So we have these two forks here, and this is pretty easy to balance, right? I'm moving around, I'm riding, I'm using a wide finger to balance this, and a horse, and this, I'm finding the center of gravity, because this is perfectly balanced, because it's not going one way or the other. If I'm too far over here, that's not perfectly balanced. So I have to find the center of it in order to get the forks equal. This is what you're doing with your body every time you're on a horse. You should be trying to stay neutral. I'm not neutral here on the forks because the forks are crooked. I'm not neutral here on the forks because the forks are crooked. I'm more neutral here, which means the forks weigh less than they do here. I feel more pressure on my finger when the forks are off balance versus when they're in the center. I feel less pressure. That's your goal when you're riding a horse. So let's look at some serious little balance issues here. So we got a toothpick, a little bitty toothpick here on two big old forks, and we'll look at these big forks as like shanks on bits that people use for leverage. We have these two long counter levers, whatever you want to call them, and I'm going to do a thing on horsepower about leverage and stuff also. I'm just still collecting data on it. So we have these two and a toothpick. So we're going to take this wine glass here, and I'm going to try and find the center of gravity of this toothpick on the edge. Oh, that didn't work. Should I cut that out or leave it? Oh, I'll leave it. Give people something. He don't even know what he's doing. He can't even do it, and he's trying, and he don't like women, and he... Shut up, you freaking crybabies. Alright, so I have the toothpick in pretty much the center, and now I am going to try to balance this on the glass and see what we got here. Oh, I broke my toothpick off. That's not good. Okay. Holy shit, it worked. So now we have perfect balance. Even though I've got the toothpick a little off-center, you can tell the forks are not that straight. But we're actually balancing on a glass that could tip over, two heavy forks that will move, and the slightest wind moves these, yet it's still balanced on just the edge. Get this a little higher up here, maybe to get that edge on there. On the edge of that toothpick, right there. Let's get a different angle. So, that right there is the center of gravity on this object. So, when you find the center of gravity, it's almost like your weightlessness. See how you can barely touch that? And it's almost like it's weight, even though it's still moving and shaking, every bit of this weight is on that little bitty tip. Okay, so here's the cool part. Most people think that we're using leverage. I want to get a little bit more balanced here. Most people think this counterweight here is leverage. Well, it's not. Because we're going to remove this excess weight here. This lighter never works. Rick, why don't you get one that works? Because all I need is a spark to light my So who thinks it's going to fall when this burns down? We're losing weight. We're losing the countermeasure. And yet, the forks aren't falling. So, how does this work? Well, I don't know. I'm not a science guy. But it freaking works. So, by understanding how important and how little something can change the balance on this, imagine when you're on a horse and you're sloppy and you're falling and your stirrups are off level and you have weak one leg, or you're overweight and your saddle is too small so you're not fitting good in the saddle, or your saddle is too big and you're really little so you're bouncing around and moving. All those minor movements, if you can find the center of gravity on your horse, it makes your ride better for you and for your horse. If you get rid of leverage to where you start taking away the horse's ability to use his head as a counterbalance, kind of like this little toothpick here, to make his ability to carry you better, to keep his balance, to run and move smoother, your horse looks better, your horse is stronger because he's carrying left weight, he can balance himself because you're not throwing off his balance with big bits, and when you balance better in a saddle, you don't throw off his balance because you learn how to stay neutral. I talk about that term a lot. You should be neutral in a saddle, not a sack of potatoes falling all over the pace, forward, backwards, left, right, looking on your phone, talking to somebody behind you, turning your head. Just turning your head throws off the center of balance. Just moving a little bit on this fork, being balanced, these long counterweights, how does that not fall off? When balance is so important when you're on a horse. And the problem is to maintain that balance, because your horse moves fast, quick, he spooks, you're not going to be able to maintain this balance here. You've got wind, you've got horse's reaction, you've got your reactions, you've got him pulling on the reins if your hands are tight, it's pulling you forward, you're pulling back, you get in a fight with your horse, you're both fighting balance. It's just, if you understand how important little bitty things like this can balance things when you get the center, and I call it a sweet spot. When you hit that sweet spot to where it's like, ah, there it is. I feel light, my horse feels strong, we're moving in unison, and we're perfectly balanced. I'm not interfering with him, and all I'm doing is being a good passenger. Okay, so that's horsey balance and forks. Hope you got something out of that. We'll end that there. Buddy, Mr. T, Ransom, Bell, you're all good boys. Darn it, I ended it too soon. I wanted to show you that for the people that thought you can only do it with the long toothpick and not after you remove it, I set these down, I can still find the center of gravity. Oh man, I lost my toothpick, damn. Okay, so I just stuck a different toothpick in on one side, but you notice you can still get the center of gravity up and down as you can sideways, and you can still get it to balance just there on that little lip. The camera doesn't really want to focus in on that real well. So that is supporting this up and down. Now, will it work with the burning? We'll see. Once I get it lit, the gas coming out will just light the rest of it. Oh, touch the glass. Don't want to do that. Now, the heat may heat up that fork. May causing issues, but we'll see. And it didn't. So, what I wanted to show you, and this isn't touching the ground, by the way. I know people are thinking it's touching, but it's not. I don't know if you can see that. Let me get down here because we'll have somebody. Rick, you cheated. It was touching. It's not touching, people. All right? It's off the table. Watch. It's off. Not touching. Are you sure, Rick? Because it looks like. All right, whatever. All right, so let's see if I can do my other experience. What I was going to do before is pull it off and then put it back on. So we're going to take it off without our little stuff, and now we're going to try to put it back on. And it worked pretty quick on that one. So that's what I was going to do and add that in last time, but I end up screwing it up and I forgot to do it when I quit. So it looks like finding that little center of gravity and balance, you can get pretty specific with it. And I think if you concentrate and aware of it, you'll become a better rider. And for sure, by giving your horse his head and not using pain bits to control it and force it and tie downs and restrict his head, because and the most reason people restrict a horse's head is because they can't control the horse without that aid. They don't understand. They say they have soft hands. They say their horse is trained. They say they're experienced riders. But yet they have to have all these gadgets, long bits, shanks, tie downs, running martingales, whatever you want to call it. They're all cheats because they don't want to admit they really don't know how to ride. They don't know how to control the horse without all that. And it's them that's the problem, not the horse. All right, we'll end that there.